Here in the wilderness all alone? I'll take you to your dad. You want to see your dad, don't you? Hey!
I'll get this one. You just make sure you kill the girl.
Oh, I'll get her. You just make sure you get him. Little lady, we can't have any witnesses.
Daddy, please help me.
You just close your eyes.
Turn around, Leah.
Put the gun down. You know what happens when you shoot an unarmed man in these parts?
Do your job, Sheriff. Shut up.
Damn it, listen to me.
I'm an honest man.
Is this one of the cowboys that killed your wife?
Last one.
Okay. Glad you found him. Now let me take him as my prisoner and you as my witness.
You put it down, Chamberlain. Put your gun down.
You can help me bring him to justice in a court of law. Good man, Chamberlain. Now let him go.
I guess I'll be getting your daughter some other time, Chamberlain.
No, you won't.
You'll hang for this.
How delightfully rustic. I haven't seen a place this filthy since Calcutta in 54.
Agreed, sir.
Ah, but that's all part of the charm, part of the adventure. Oh, good. It looks as though someone has noticed my money.
May I introduce you to Baron Charles Emerson of Yorkshire.
Good day to you, sir. May I welcome you to Franklin County. We have all the hospitality and comfort you could want. I'm Mayor Codswell, and I'm at your service. It's a pleasure to meet you, sir.
Oh, the pleasure is all mine, good sir. Now, if I may, you mentioned hospitality.
Oh, yes, we have a hotel, a saloon, and a brothel. Well, just about the sweetest ladies you ever did see.
How very inviting. And what of the war?
Oh, the war don't come close to us. You have nothing to fear.
Oh, I am not afraid of the war. I am in awe of it. But first things first, dear Mayor. I hope you don't mind my saying, but I'm wildly attracted by your topper.
My hat.
Indeed. And if I am to acclimate to your culture, blend in, so to speak, I'm going to need it.
Well, I'm going to be honest with you, sir. Baron, with this much money, you could buy 10 hats. We have a general store in town that sells them.
Well, I don't need 10 hats. I need but one. This one, in particular.
Well, my pleasure. Hey, is there anything else we can do for you?
Well, yes, I read in the newspapers recently that your sheriff apprehended a desperado.
Oh, yes, we're mighty proud of our sheriff for apprehending that varmint. We're hanging that murderous Chamberlain character tomorrow. I can get you a seat at the hanging if you like.
Ah, simple entertainment for good, simple people.
Mr. Chamberlain claims he murdered those men in self-defense. Now, we got no proof of that, of course. Those men were slaughtered in cold blood. Highly suspect, if you ask me.
Now I know why they call this the Wild West.
Well, the West has been known for its outlaws, but we're bringing that to an end here in Franklin County. We're going to make an example of this Mr. Chamberlain.
I am sure that there are truer words that have never been spoken, dear Mayor. Now, about that brothel.
Well, right this way. Your Chinaman will have to stay out back in the alley, of course.
Naturally.
Serve notice to you, Mr. Chamberlain. According to the laws of this state, that as you stand convicted of murder, your daughter is to be placed in the custody of a mission orphanage.
No, no, you can't take my daughter. Please.
You're scheduled to hang tomorrow, Mr. Chamberlain. At least you got a fair trial, unlike the men you murdered.
Those men killed my wife and they were going to kill my daughter if I didn't get to them first.
The sheriff didn't believe you. The jury didn't believe you, and the judge didn't believe you. And even if I did, it wouldn't make any difference. My job is to serve notice. I've done that. Say goodbye to your father, child.
Daddy, don't let her take me. When Mommy went to heaven, he promised me that we would always be together.
It's time to go.
No, wait, wait.
Prolonging this is pointless.
You're gonna be okay, baby. I promise. I love you so much. Okay, Dad. Come along. Good day to you, sir.
I present Baron Charles Emerson of Yorkshire.
Always a pleasure to meet a lawman.
Can I help you folks with something?
Of all the places I've been, this Wild West of yours intrigues me the most. You have everything, from gunslingers to grizzly bears. You have the noble, savage Indian. You have a virgin frontier.
You have a lust for gold, for women, and for whiskey. And above all else, you have lawlessness. And that, my bucolic friend, is what brings me here today.
You looking for lawlessness?
No, no, but I am looking for an outlaw. And if I understand it correctly, you currently have one in your custody. A particularly ruthless example.
That ain't the half of it, let me tell you.
Is he dangerous?
And how? He killed 4 men. Killed a couple of them fellas with his bare hands. I could let you have a look-see for 2 bits. Or you can just wait till tomorrow noon and see him swing for free.
Ah, you're a businessman. How fortuitous, for I have a proposition for you. A very lucrative one.
What exactly are you getting at?
I would like to pay you money.
You want to pay me? For what?
I would like to pay you $500.
$500?
All you have to do is to turn your back for a few minutes.
Turn my back? To what?
Your prisoner. I need him.
You want me to give you the prisoner?
No, no, no. I want you to turn your back and think of all the ways you'll spend your money. I'll take the prisoner myself.
But he's supposed to be hanged tomorrow. And I'll lose my job.
And just how much do you earn on this, job?
$2 a week.
So I am willing to pay you 5 years of your wages. And all you have to do is to close your eyes for 2 minutes. That's a rather large raise.
But I won't have my badge no more.
You can tell everyone you fought valiantly against us. We won't say a word. And you may even emerge from this a hero.
You think people are going to believe that an old guy and a Chinaman roughed up Buford M. Wallace and rode off with his prisoner? That's going to be pretty hard to believe. Mister.
Present Baron Charles...
Not necessary, my boy. He and I shall speak here as equals. How do you do, Mr. Chamberlain? My name is Charles. I've come a long way to meet you. Quite an impressive specimen. Wouldn't you agree?
No, sir. Not to me.
Oh, come now, lad. Don't be rude. Note the ferocity in his eye, like that of a lion. I hunted a lion, a huge male, on the Serengeti in my early years. Its speed and strength proved less formidable than my own skills. As a matter of fact, it was a rather easy kill. I'm curious to find out whether you will fare better. I can see in your eyes you're already plotting an escape. And that you would happily kill both me and my valet in order to achieve it.
Oh, I admire that. It confirms one of the reasons I sought you out in the first place. However, I can assure you that that will be totally unnecessary, for when we have concluded our conversation here, I and my valet will free you from your chains and will spirit you out of here.
Say again.
Ah, so you do understand. My friend, I am a hunter. I have hunted all the great beasts of the world, from the lion to the olifant, the panther, and the Kodiak bear, and I have killed them all. But alas, they were all too easy. Never once did I experience the thrill of my own mortality. So I took the next logical step. I began hunting people. But not just any people willy-nilly, no. I began to target the world's great warriors. I killed a mighty Maori in New Zealand, a ferocious Sikh in the sweltering Punjab, and even a fearsome Zulu or two on the plains of southern Africa. And let me show you this. This was bestowed upon me by a samurai. Do you know what a samurai is? The samurai are the most incredible warriors. Intensely trained, highly skilled, devilishly clever and quick. The one I hunted almost killed me. Oh, it was a gruesome, bloody fight to the death. But, as you can see, it was I who prevailed in the end. The point is, I have traveled far and wide to hunt some of the world's greatest warriors. And now, I am here for you. The great Western desperado, the ruthless outlaw who can kill men with his bare hands.
Is it just me, or is the air fresher at this altitude?
I diverted your judgment, sir.
I believe it is. And it has just inspired me, Kowloon.
How so, sir?
Perhaps after this adventure, we should travel to Nepal. The mountains there are even higher than these. There is a mountain range there called the Kanchenjunga. I believe it would make for a challenging hunting ground.
If you say so, sir.
I knew it.
Just as I predicted. He's taking the north side down instead of the eastern side, which is considerably easier. This means he understands what is happening and is using tactical thinking in order to elude me. What a promising beginning. Let's get going, Kowloon. Don't dawdle.
He thinks my little gift might be a trap. He doesn't know me. He may think I'm just out for the kill, but it's the hunt that is everything. I am fair with my prey. One thing I am not, however, is patient.
That was just a warning shot, Mr. Chamberlain. But now, cry havoc!
Informed as to the range of your weapon. Why do you think I'm standing so far back? However, I am also informed as to the extreme range of my rifle.
This is getting very interesting. And isn't that what life is all about? Fair fights, a level playing field. Kowloon, I'm switching to revolver. Let me have no advantage. Thank you. Stay in good cover, Kowloon.
I count six, Mr. Chamberlain. You are out of ammunition. I am not. Kowloon. That was exhilarating. Now, please hand me my rifle. And be so kind as to reload that.
Thank you.
Nothing feels better than existing exactly the way we were meant to. I never feel more alive than when I'm on the hunt.
I've noticed that, sir.
And have you noticed this? Tracks remain steady in one general direction. This only occurs when one knows where one is headed. Could it be he is familiar with this terrain?
It's possible we didn't take him far enough away from town.
So based on what you know, Kowloon, what would you say our chances are?
I never bet against you, sir.
A fine sentiment, but this is not about gambling. It's about education. Observe this hunt closely. For it may be of value to you one day. Well, off we go. Regrettably, my boy, age makes fools of us all. But it's not over. We'll split up. I'll continue to follow his tracks, and you flank him from the north. He is likely exhausted as well. If you spot him, fire this into the air. The kill is mine, remember.
Guns are for old men and women. We are neither. You know how to fight like a man.
Yes, I do. So you don't like guns?
No. Guns are for cowards.
Didn't your people invent gunpowder?
The Baron thinks highly of your skill as a warrior. I don't.
Thank you. I don't take kindly to trespassers here. Now, put your hands up.
Oh, no. Please don't be dead, for I will never be able to forgive you.
Forgive me for what, sir?
For dying before you have truly lived, my boy.
I met Mr. Chamberlain. He wanted to leave. I thought he should stay. You were late, sir.
My apologies. I lost the trail, briefly. So, you fought?
Yes.
So now he is dead. Well, I specifically reserved the pleasure of the kill to myself.
He's alive, and fairly well, sir.
How is that possible?
He cheated. Threw a rock at me.
A rock? Well, that is simply not cricket. But that would explain your current discomfort. It would also explain your mistake.
My mistake?
Yes. You assumed you were fighting a civilized man, not a barbarian who makes up his own rules as he goes along. But no harm done. Except to you, of course. One day you may thank Mr. Chamberlain for this encounter. As we learn more from our failures than our successes, this has made you smarter, stronger, and deadlier. Do you understand?
I do, sir.
Good. Well, now that you're alive and sufficiently rested, I want you to set up camp here for the night. The hunt will resume on the morrow. In earnest.
We don't get many visitors around these parts.
We?
Okay. I don't get many visitors.
You here alone?
No. I'm here with my friend, Winchester. Oh, I took your gun. You didn't have any ammunition, anyway.
Any menfolk around here?
The war took my brother and my father.
Husband?
The war didn't take him. He left on his own.
You got any children?
Not that is any of your business. No. That's why my husband left.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Don't be.
Mind if I join you at the table?
So, what are you doing here in the middle of nowhere? Are you running from the law?
Something worse.
How can I help you?
Water.
Kowloon. One should never pass up the opportunity to admire something like this.
Sir, the hunt.
If we should let something as magnificent as this pass our gaze without notice, we should rightly be called joyless. We aren't merely out for a kill. That would make us no better than the animals. But we better ourselves with the hunt. By challenging and defeating a worthy opponent, we improve ourselves. Experiencing joy is a part of that process.
Understood, sir.
Now, did we bring along that old whiskey that we procured in Scotland?
Yes, sir.
And what does that whiskey prove?
That even the Scottish aren't completely useless.
You learn very well. Now, be a good lad and pour me a small shot.
got a lot of nice tools here.
Yeah, my father was a blacksmith. Do you know how to use them?
My grandfather taught me how.
It's a shame they're going to waste now.
This place is a paradise.
It could be. You know, you could stay here for a few days, just long enough to regain your strength.
I wish I could. I really do.
You got someone waiting on you?
Yes, ma'am.
A special someone?
Yes, ma'am.
I was thinking, you know, you could use some extra time. I've been alone for a long time. I'm used to it. Oh, your gun. I have some extra ammo, so I loaded it for you. Go on, take it.
Prepare yourself, Kowloon. The chase is about to resume. Seems that for the first time we may have a surrender on our hands. I may have misjudged this Western warrior.
So did I once.
Hold there. Do I surmise that you acquiesce to my superior skill and tenacity?
Hell no.
And what the devil are you doing? My sense of fair play does have its limit.
I say we end this here. Now.
I see. And how exactly do you propose to accomplish that?
You and me, man to man. Pistols. Until it's done.
A duel? Kowloon, this hunt has suddenly started to exceed my wildest expectations. And what are the Western rules?
Unholster your weapon fast and aim true.
Simple enough. Very well. I find your terms to be very agreeable. Would you allow me, on your honor, to properly equip myself? I admire this man, Kowloon. So much so that I believe that I must kill him now.
Excellent.
Take cover, Kowloon. I shouldn't be but a moment.
Bested at last, Kowloon. But do not despair, for I have lived my life. I have truly lived.
I don't know what I'll do.
Nonsense. I have taught you well, and I am prepared for the unexpected. In my pocket, you will find my legal will. I leave all my remaining wealth to you. Wisely. Improve yourself. Always. Never stop advancing. Do you hear?
But Baron, don't leave.
Ta-ta, my boy. I'm merely embarking on another adventure. The greatest one of all.
Okay, is everybody here?
Buford, where's the sheriff?
He went to county seat for court day.
He even know you pulled up a posse?
He left me in charge, didn't he?
Seems strange to leave you in charge after you lost that important prisoner.
I didn't lose anybody. His gang came, took him from me.
I'm a hired gun. I ain't gonna do this for no pay.
You're gonna get paid. And don't forget I overlooked the fact that you're a deserter. Did your time, my ass. You jumped 2 feet when you saw my badge yesterday. And don't forget I know something about every man here. Now, does anybody else want to shoot off your mouth? I didn't think so.
What's the plan?
Chamberlain's gonna try and sneak in here all quiet-like. Slip away with his little girl before anyone knows he's here. Here comes Mrs. Havishaw from the orphanage. She has our bait.
But ain't it wrong to use a man's kid bait?
Ain't it wrong to gun people down in cold blood? That man's wanted for murder.
Mr. Wallace, did I just hear one of your men refer to this innocent child as bait?
He didn't mean nothing by it.
I should hope not. Have you men been drinking?
No more than normal for a man who's putting his life on the line.
All liquored up, waiting for a gunfight?
I closed the streets off. You shouldn't even be here, Miss Havishaw.
In case you've forgotten, you were the one that told us to be here.
All right. Why don't you go wait in the office then? Go in the back. No stray bullet should get you there. Go on now, get!
You know why I'm here.
Oh, I know a lot of things.
Don't you mess with me, Buford. I want my daughter. I won't take her out of here. We all live. I know you got those men with you. And if you try anything, as God is my witness, I will kill every last one of you sons of bitches. So what's it gonna be, Buford? Just you and me. Who is that?
It's an army deserter. Came here yesterday.
No, it's not. It's a famous outlaw, Chamberlain. You got him. He killed your posse, but you killed him.
I killed him. What about?
Well, congratulations, Deputy. Looks like you're gonna be a hero in everyone's eyes. Most everyone.
Maybe you'll even get a reward. But you make damn sure he's buried before the sheriff gets back. You do it yourself, you hear?
Is this the special someone you told me about?
Yeah. This is my daughter, Leah.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I was wondering if you still needed that blacksmith.
Well, it's not a temporary position.
Thank you.
I've known dark skies, the clouds, tears all over me, but I think there's something better than this, there's something better than this, there's something better, so much better, something better than this, I know there is, if the sun smiles, it's what I something better, so much better, something better.